Hey there, Capricorn. This is your reading for April 2023. What's going on with Capricorn? And if this reading resonates, please like and subscribe, okay? And if it doesn't resonate at this time, make sure to take a look at your other placements. They may be resonating more for you, okay? So let's take a look. What's going on with Capricorn? Let's get some of your energy. What's going on in April? Okay, we have unrequited love. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. Wow, okay. Unrequited love. At the bottom we have make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you've guided to take. Okay, so there may be some kind of effort. Your relationship may be a little strained at this time. There may be someone who's feeling a little unfulfilled in your relationship if you are in a current relationship. If you're not in a current relationship, I feel like you're just dating. You're just, you know, you're looking for that certain someone, but I feel like you may be in, you know, not really finding someone that's really appealing for you. We're going to go ahead and get more energy for you and kind of elaborate a little bit more on the situation, okay? So let's take a look. What else is going on? Let's get some energy for Capricorn. Give me more messages. Okay, we have clairaudience. Okay, we have Archangel Zadkiel. Okay, I notice the loving guidance you hear inside your mind and from other people. Right? So I feel like you are kind of feeling, maybe you're becoming very empathetic at this time. Maybe you're feeling other people's emotions. You're kind of not able to see what may be happening, right? But I feel like you're very empathetic at this time. You feel very greatly another person's emotions, another person's feelings, right? You're able to kind of empathize with them. See, we have the tribe. Okay, the number 8. So with the tribe, I feel like you're surrounding yourself by people who love you. You may be very social at this time. I feel like you are, you know, surrounding yourself with people and going to familiar places, you know. But you are surrounding yourself with love, with happiness, with people who care, you know. You are surrounding yourself with your tribe, your soul tribe, the people who care for you, the people who love you, right? Let's take a look and see what's going on with Capricorn and love. So this may be your family, your friends, your social group that you're hanging out with. You're getting out there, you're networking. But I've, you know, like with this card, I feel like, you know, if you're not attached, I feel like you're very social, you know. We have keys on a ring. So you have many options. You have many decisions. So like I said, I feel like, you know, you're looking for that special someone, but you're having fun. You're living your life. You're getting out there and dating, right? And this may happen after some kind of breakup or separation. That it could be that the person that you're dating is kind of out of your distance at the moment. You may not be having very much contact if you are together. I feel like that's the reason for this unrequited love here. because it's just not working out. Maybe there's too much distance. There's too much separation between you. So you feel like you're weighing your options, like you're looking for something else, right? It may be that you may travel a lot for work, or you may travel a lot. Your person may travel, or maybe they live in another city, a good distance away. But I feel like there's some sort of separation between you and this person. And that's like causing a gap here. It's causing some kind of friction to where, you know, you're really weighing your options. You're seeing what else is out there, okay? So let's go ahead and take a look at the tarot. Let's see what's going on for Capricorn. Message for Capricorn, please. April 2023. Message for Capricorn. Okay, yeah. We have the Ten of Wands, the Five of Cups, the Justice card, the Ten of Swords, the Four of Cups, the Eight of Swords, and the Seven of Pentacles. Wow, yeah. At the bottom, we have the Chariot. So you're definitely moving. You're moving into some kind of better situation. You feel a great weight. You know, you may have felt a great weight. Like you're carrying a lot of burdens. You're carrying a lot of stress, a lot of priorities. And you feel like, you know, there's something that you need to let go of. There's something that just has to go. You may be focusing on the things that may be most important to you. But I feel like there's things that you're releasing. There's things that you're letting go of. Because you feel like you've just outgrown the situation. Or it just isn't working the way that you planned. Right? So I feel like there's a need for you to find this balance and to make hard decisions to end a situation. I feel like this is a very hard decision. This is something that you're doing for your greatest good, right? You kind of feel like in order to have that balance to move into something better, whatever this is, it needed to go. It needed to end because it just wasn't what you expected. It wasn't what you wanted. This may be a relationship. This may be friends. This may be, you know, a job that feels like it's dead end. Like there's nowhere else to go. You know, you may feel stuck, right? So I feel like you're making the effort to do something good, to do something right, you know? And I feel like you're contemplating, you're feeling very unfulfilled and unappreciated in your situation, and it's holding you back. You're thinking of the possibilities. You may be daydreaming about what could be, right? But I feel like there's something holding you back. There's something stopping you from taking advantage of something that could possibly bring you more happiness, more feelings of being fulfilled, right? I feel like there's something holding you back from this. We're going to take a look and clarify these cards. But I do feel like even though there's something holding you back, I feel like you are able to grow in this situation. You just need to plant the seeds. You need to plant the seeds and grow into whatever this is. Because I feel like the seeds that you plant today are going to be something that you value tomorrow, right? And I feel like Spirit is telling you, you know, stop restricting yourself. Stop feeling stuck. It's time to get moving, take action, plant these seeds, because these seeds will be valuable, right? So there's something that you are growing into, you know? There's something that you have the ability to take advantage of, but you're kind of distancing yourself at the moment. You're kind of holding yourself back for some reason. Maybe it's fear, maybe it's doubt, you know, doubt that you have the ability. But I do feel like there's something bigger, there's something better that you can do, right? So let's get some clarity through these cards. Tell me more about this message for Capricorn. Tell me more about this message for Capricorn. And I'm just getting this message, but it could be like, for example, if you've been in a position for a very long time and then you're offered a new position, you feel very doubtful. You're kind of holding yourself back that you have the ability to do that higher position that's been offered for you, right? But yeah, that's just an example. Take it how it resonates here, okay? So let's get a message. The Two of Cups, the Sun, wow, the Emperor, the Knight of Pentacles, and the King of Swords. Wow, you're not holding back. You are freeing yourself of this situation in April. You're not restricting yourself. You're actually, you know, you're overcoming hurdles, boundaries, obstacles, right? At the bottom, we have you, very strong, Capricorn. So I feel like you're definitely taking some sort of action. You know, you're not being held back anymore. You're like, I'm not going to be bound anymore. I'm not going to let anything negative hold me back. I'm going to keep working at this. I'm going to keep working. I'm going to keep networking. I'm going to surround myself with people who are very supportive, very caring. Okay? So, yeah, that's beautiful, Capricorn. So, I feel like, you know, with this Ten of Wands and this Five of Cups, I feel like, you know, that there's something that you're releasing in order to feel more supported. You know, this could be some kind of partnership. This could be some sort of union that you're letting go of. But I feel like, you know, there may be someone new who is actually, you know, getting your attention. They're making you very happy in this situation with this Two of Cups and the Sun, you know? So I feel like with this hard decision that you had to make, this hard decision that you had to let go of, you're happy with your decision. You're happy that you made that choice because it's all working out. It you know, the Sun is shining through. You have your abundance. You have, you know, this happy ending here from, you know, what you were so scared to leave behind, right? So you definitely have your justice here in your situation, you know, and I feel like you're able to take more control. You feel more in control of your situation. You feel like, you know, whatever comes forward, you can handle because you are the Emperor. You're taking on those characteristics. You know, the Emperor, they're also a master manifester. So this is a very good time for you to manifest, put those intentions out there for something that you want. Okay, this Emperor here, he's a master manifester. He's able to manifest anything he desires. So now's the time to put your intentions out there and make your intentions known for something that you want to manifest, something that you want to bring down to earth. Because I feel like you have a lot of control at this time. You're taking on the characteristics of the Emperor. You're also, you may be a very good entrepreneur at this moment, but I feel like you are taking the authority, right? And I feel like, you know, you are taking a look at a very solid offer. you're getting a better understanding of this offer, and you're weighing your pros and cons here, you know? But you're not holding yourself back. You're giving yourself the ability to grow, to really think about the situation, to really think about the possibilities. But this is a very solid offer that's coming in for you. This is something that's being gifted, something that's being offered to you. Okay? And I feel like you're going to find this very valuable. You're going to find this very appealing. Okay? And with this devil card at the bottom, I feel like, you know, you are in your power. Definitely. You know, you're coming out very strong. You don't expect that you have the power that you have, you know, but you're digging down deep. You're pulling out that personal power that you have, and you're surrounding yourself with that support system, with those people who are building you up, who are giving you good advice, you know, building up your self-esteem, your ego, right? So very interesting here. Capricorn, let's go ahead and get some romance tarot. Let's see what we have here for Capricorn. Give me a message, please, for Capricorn. Okay. We have Healer of Action. So this is the Queen of Wands energy. This is a time when you can do whatever you set your mind to if your heart is open. You're being asked to do many things at once. You won't mind as long as you know that you're making a difference. This card indicates that someone who's loving, intelligent, passionate, and fun, which could definitely describe you. This person can also handle difficult situations with ease. Okay, with grace. And we also have the Helper of Thought. This is the Knight of Swords. Okay, so your life is about to start moving very fast. Events that seem to be on hold suddenly require all your attention. There's no time to sit and ponder. You've got to get moving. Review the details as best you can. You know, we'll meet and are someone with a very quick mind. Let's see. You know, we'll meet and are someone with a very quick mind who instantly grasps what to do. This person is both confident and courageous. Okay. All right. And we have two. So let's take a look at those. Okay, so we have the Nine of Abundance, the Nine of Pentacles. Life is wonderful, and your hard work and dedication to your dreams will provide you with great peace and contentment. Take time to enjoy quiet moments of reflection and leisure. Feel free to buy yourself some small, luxurious gifts. You've earned the financial security and independence you now enjoy. So yeah, you are going to have some kind of increase that's coming in for you, right? And we also have the Eight of Action. So this is the Eight of Wands energy. There's so much going on right now that it may feel overwhelming to you, and yet it's wonderful to be so busy with the work that you love. Express gratitude for the blessings of heaven and that are taking up your time. Even if life feels challenging, if you're asked to travel and take a flight, then do so with confidence, okay? And at the bottom, we have the Ace of Action. This is the Ace of Wands energy. Okay, so there's definitely some kind of new beginning, new venture that you're going on. This cherub is heralding a time of wonderful new opportunities related to your creativity, your career, and pursuing your dreams. This is a card of action, and if you've been procrastinating, it's time to really get busy. It's also a great time to start a new business, have confidence in your abilities. Okay, so definitely new beginnings. I think Spirit is really letting you know this is the time to take action. Something great is available and possible, right? So whatever you're thinking about doing, if you feel like it's time to maybe start a business, maybe do something new, pursue a hobby, just create, you know, this is the time to start. Just start. Just do it. Okay? We have full moon in Taurus. Detoxify. So you may want to get rid of those negative feelings or the negative things that you may be putting into your body. So this may be a good time to detoxify and kind of go through a cleanse, right? And we have full moon in Leo. Go wild. What was I saying? Just do it. Just put yourself out there. Take a risk. Take a leap. And just do something that feels right. Okay? So let's get a Moonology card for Capricorn. Let's see this one. You are good enough. Okay? You have the ability. You're stronger than you know. Okay? Be bold and make the first move. So it is time, it's definitely time to take action. It's time to start pursuing your dreams that you may have been putting on hold. But it's time to take action. You have a lot of wands here, right? So Spirit is letting you know it's time to get a move on. Okay, we have the snake. There's some kind of rebirth. There's something that you're releasing. And there's something that you're evolving. When you look at a snake, you look at them shedding their skin, you know? They're renewing their skin every so often. Don't ask me how often that is because I really don't know, but I know that they shed their skin to, you know, reveal this new skin underneath. So I feel like you are revealing who you really are by shedding that old comfort that you're constantly putting yourself in. Maybe it's time to move away from that comfort zone, right? But I feel like, you know, there's something that you're releasing so that something can come through. Okay, let's take a look. What angel number do we have for Capricorn? What does Capricorn need to know, please? A message for Capricorn. Yeah, look at this. 999, release. There's something that you're releasing. Okay? Endings are new beginnings in disguise. An ending symbolizes closure of one door and an opening of another. The whisper is reminding you to release and allow. It is in the release where the magic happens, right? So, your affirmation, Capricorn. Doors open for me where others have closed, beginning transformation to my mind, my body, and my soul. So, yeah, there's some kind of transforming going on here. You know, you're shedding your skin. You're moving away from your comfort zone. It's time to pursue that dream, that, you know, career, that new relationship that you've been hoping for. It's time to take that leap, okay? So, Capricorn, I hope this message receives you well. And if it resonates, please like and subscribe. If it doesn't resonate, please take a look at your other placements. They may be resonating more at this time. But many blessings to you, Capricorn, okay? And love and light.